Elephants are large, majestic, and beautiful yet dangerous animals. When a crying and injured elephant approached some rangers in Zimbabwe's Manapul's National Park, they noticed something very strange and concerning. It wasn't until they got a closer look that they realized exactly what had happened to him. Zimbabwe's Manapul's National Park is located in the far north of the country, and it is known for the large amounts of wildlife visible around the river and the floodplains. Large and dense populations of elephants, hippos, and crocodiles gather in the famous Long Pool, while lions wait for prey around the waterhole at Sitako Spring. Animals live in relative peace and harmony, safe from the dangers of the outside world. There is an abundance of wildlife, and that's what makes this national park so special. It wasn't unusual to see rhinos hanging around with hippos or crocodiles placidly lying on the banks of the waters as deer quietly drank. It's what made the park so peaceful. But at 219,600 hectares, 540 acres, it covered a lot of area. If you were looking for a specific animal, the task might prove nigh impossible without some kind of trackers or assistance. There were plenty of rangers around, though, patrolling the areas, keeping an eye on animals, checking in on sick or injured critters, and on rare catchings, chasing away poachers that had strayed into the park in order to shoot and bring home a prize. For the most part, though, there was very little drama or cause for concern. That was until something very strange happened one day. As a team of rangers was driving through the territory owned primarily by the large and brash elephants, things were quiet as usual, and nothing much seemed to be going on. Mid was a pandemic, so they decided to pull into the shade of a tree, have a break, and drink some water in the relative coolness. But then, out of the distance started lumbering an elephant, a huge bull elephant at that. While many people believe elephants to be gentle and cute animals, they are often angry and violent too. They can be extremely territorial, and their anger combined with their size can make them extremely formidable opponents. Rangers tended not to spend time around the large bull elephants at all, as they were prone to attack and charge their vehicles without any warning. Their tasks could easily pierce the windows and doors and cause fatal injuries. So when one bull elephant known as Pretty Boy started to make his way towards the vehicle, they were ready to speed away and to safety. It wasn't worth the risk of hanging around. Fully grown male elephants can stand up to 4 meters or 13 feet tall, and weigh up to 6,000 kilograms or 15,000 pounds on average. It takes around 35 to 40 years for males to reach their full size, and they can live in the wild for up to 60 to 70 years. Male elephants are super strong too. In fact, they can carry up to 9,000 kilograms or 20,000 pounds, which is equivalent to the weight of 130 adult humans. It's no wonder why the rangers were so hasty to get out of the massive elephant's path. But just before the ranger being the wheel turned on the ignition and started to drive away, he noticed something was wrong with the elephant. It seemed to be walking towards them, almost as if it were in a daze. It had tears in its eyes too, and streaks of water running down its dusty cheeks, indicating that it was crying. This was enough to cause the rangers to pause. Pretty Boy continued to walk slowly towards the vehicle, but he was displaying no aggressive behavior. In fact, it seemed as if he was trying to get their attention, as if he were begging for help. It was rare to see an elephant cry. Yes, elephants are intelligent, complicated, and emotional animals. They feel many of the same emotions that we humans do and even celebrate good things happening while also mourning the loss of one of their own. But to see an elephant truly upset is alerting. When they feel such emotions, they tend to stick closer to others in their herd. So for Pretty Boy to be so openly approaching the rangers in such a state of emotional distress was something that caused everyone quite a bit of worry. Looking closer, the elephant seemed to be injured. He was crying tears of pain. Now, elephants did often get injured in the preserve. Sometimes they slipped, tripped, and fell, causing cuts and bruises on their bodies or even breaking bones. At times, bull elephants would get into fights with each other and inflict huge, painful-looking gashes on their opponents' bodies. But Pretty Boy wasn't sporting any of those kinds of injuries. In fact, his injury looked decidedly abnormal. It was causing the rangers so much concern that they decided to radio for one of their colleagues who specialized in elephants and elephant treatment to come out with a tranquilizer gun. If they wanted to get a closer look, see that ingin was the only way. It took the specialist bet around 45 minutes to reach the scene. All the while, pretty boy just stood there, looking pleadingly at the rangers. They used binoculars to try to get a closer look at the injury, but they couldn't make out too much, not at that distance and not with pretty boy wobbling and dragging so wildly. All they knew was that there was some kind of bleeding injury on his head, and that it looked very painful. No one could fathom what had happened to the poor elephant, but they were all shaken to their core when they eventually found out. The specialist arrived and leveled his tranquilizer gun at pretty boy, firing it into his left side. Almost immediately, the giant elephant fell to his knees, rolling and landing on his side. The rangers still gave him a few minutes until they approached, just to make sure that he was actually tranquilized. So on an oak talk, they started to slowly approach, straining to see what had caused the injury. Whatever it was, they would have to work fast. Pretty boy would only be unconscious for around 30 minutes, maybe less. One of the rangers stood back and looked for signs that he was awakening, while the team got to work studying and treating the animal. They took blood samples, looked over his entire body, and made their way to Pretty Boy's head to check out the most obvious wound there. But what they saw shocked and appalled them. It was worse than any of them had feared. It seemed that Pretty Boy had been shot in the forehead, most probably by a poacher. There was a roundel surrounded by blood, whipping Kitty heavily. Thankfully, the bullet had not broken through his skull and pierced his brain. If it had, Pretty Boy would have died then and there. This elephant was both lucky and unlucky at the same time. He was unlucky because he had been shot, but lucky because he had survived it. It seems the poacher who shot him must have been inexperienced at bringing down animals of that size. The round was far too small to kill an elephant, but it had still caused a lot of painful damage. The impact of the bullet had dashed poor Pretty Boy, which is what was making him so placid and tranquil. The rangers and the vet worked hard to remove the bullet fragment from the wound and made sure they flushed it out properly to avoid any infection taking hold. While the bullet and the brought Pretty Boy down, a nasty infection surely would. The team finished treating the elephant and retreated back to their vehicles, waiting for him to awaken. Eventually, he came around, seemingly confused and still somewhat dazed. He sat for a long while before heaving himself back to his feet. The vets would keep a close eye on Pretty Boy for the foreseeable future. He had been smart enough to go to the humans for help, even though he had been injured by one of them. The rangers vowed to continue their fight to defend the elephants and other animals of the Manapouls National Park and get rid of poachers forever. So now it's over to you. What did you think of this incredible story? How would you have reacted if you had been approached by a crying elephant? Would you have tried to help, or would you have left it and let nature take its course? As always, we love to hear from you, so be sure to leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments section down below. For a Kinsemereten man who sad to die in birds, he was happy to save to lives, not to mention that it was just a matter of little effort. The man never thought that what he thought was just a matter of little effort would have such an unexpected ending. It must be the most miraculous and shocking scene he has ever seen in his life. Joseph Sakar lives on a quiet street in a coastal city in India in an old neighborhood that he loves. Joseph is an electrician, but he also works part-time with photography and videography, which is also a hobby of his. There was nothing special about Joseph. He was just an ordinary person living an ordinary life, but one day, something very extraordinary happened to him. This morning, Joseph worked very early. He poured himself a cup of coffee. After all, the hassle of sleep was still in front of him. Before starting a new day, he needed to refresh himself. Joseph took a sip of his coffee before opening the balcony door to let in the cool morning air, but just then he noticed something unusual, and out of the corner of his eye caught a glimpse of green in the corner of the balcony. Joseph didn't put any extra decorations on the balcony, only a chair and a small table, so Joseph felt very novel to see such vibrant and colorful things. His eyes widened in surprise as he turned his head to observe the object hidden in the corner of the balcony. It was not a green inanimate thing, but to emerald green parakeets. Parrots are quite intelligent species of birds and they like warm and balmy climates, which is why they are so common in India. Joseph had seen many parakeets before, but never this close to them, and they found it very strange why they were on his balcony, and what was even more strange was that they did not fly away when Joseph approached them. Parakeets are common in these areas, and Joseph recalls encountering them before, but they tend to be solitary and don't like being near people. Although sometimes they have to be brave, like rushing to steal some leftovers when Joseph left the plate on the balcony, but then they fly away quickly, and they don't stop. This area has just recently been hit by a typhoon, thank God, Joseph's home survived, but many buildings were destroyed, many people even lost their lives, even the animals have not been able to escape the clutches of nature. It seems that these two birds will hide on Joseph's balcony, because they are the victims of this disaster. When the two birds saw Joseph close in front of them, they were very scared, but their wings were damaged, which made them unable to fly, and naturally they could not distance themselves from Joseph. They are such beautiful creatures, but they can't open their wings at this time. If they are left alone, they will starve to death because they can't find food. Joseph didn't want to see such a tragedy happen. He went back to the house and went to the kitchen to find some food. Joseph has never raised birds before, so there is no special food for birds at home, he can only bring them some rice. Seeing the long lost food, the two little birds called out excitedly. When Joseph approached, the birds were looking stronger and healthier. It was finally time for their bodies to heal, and the two birds began to try to fly again. Although they fell several times, they flew higher and higher each time during these failed attempts, and the birds began to regain their confidence, exercise his ability to fly. For a while now, Joseph would sit on the other side of the patio and watch the birds practice their flight, and they would take small steps to help them regain their flying skills more quickly. Would the two birds have survived if it wasn't for Joseph? We can't be sure, but what we do know for sure is that with Joseph by his side, they had a greater chance to soar again and greater confidence to overcome failure. Slowly, the two parakeets began to return to normal, but compared with before, they had a clear difference. They were no longer intimidated by Joseph's presence, and they gradually understood that Joseph was helping them, and gradually developed trust in him. As time went on, the birds began to flap their wings around the patio, turning to the outdoors at times, only to return to the spot soon after, as if Joseph's patio was their new home of choice. The existence of the two little birds began to attract the attention of the neighbors. They were amazed at the friendliness and intimacy between Joseph and them. They often teased that Joseph was chosen by nature. It was shocking that even the birds chose to stay here. One of Joseph's neighbors said there was some sort of sacred trust between Joseph and the two birds. Joseph loves these two little birds very much, he has never had a pet before, but he finds that he really enjoys being with the birds, feeding them, watching them and caring for them. Unfortunately, one person was not too happy about the birds era evil. Joseph's landlord, who believed Joseph had pets without his permission, warned Joseph to either drive the birds away or move out of the house. Joseph argued that they were used on the patio, a place open to nature and animals. One morning Joseph went out from his work and came out on the terrace to see a sad thing. Two little birds perched on the edge of the fence flew away, and this time they set off for the sea. Although Joseph was reluctant, he understood that the birds belonged to nature, and he had completed his mission. Joseph's life returned to calm. He thought they would never see those two birds again. Although they had only been together for a short time, they had already established a friendship that would never forget each other. Joseph would still think of the two cute parrots from time to time. But what Joseph didn't expect was that after a week or two, the two birds came back, but this time it was more than one bird, and they brought friends. It started with just one or two extra birds, and as time went on, more and more birds flocked to Joseph's patio. Maybe the two birds who were helped by Joseph told their companions that the terrace was a safe place, they were not afraid of Joseph, and they came here with their friends and family every time, as if thanking Joseph, showing that they trust him. Come to see Joseph's bird population is growing wildly. In just a few days, 4,000 parrots came to Joseph's balcony, and the number continues to grow. Now at least 3,000 parrots come here in any season. During the rainy season, their numbers can even swell to 6,000 individuals, and these numbers increase further during hurricanes. Joseph's landlord was unhappy, but Joseph didn't care. The birds came to his patio regularly, whether they were looking for food or shelter. Joseph was happy to provide them with whatever they needed, every now and then, and to pinch himself, it was a miraculous sight.